All right, it's the scheduled time. We can get started. We have already formed a quorum. Members, the meeting is now called to order. Information papers issued since the last meeting. Papers have been issued since the last meeting. A total of two have been issued since the last meeting, and details have been set up in the agenda. And then concerning our discussion items up to the 3rd of July 2015, we have already prepared the list. So these are the outstanding items for discussion. So any questions? If not, then let's invite the administration and the MTRCL's representatives to join us.
请政府代表和港铁
Please invite the government officials and the MTRCL representatives to join us.
出席我们今天的会议呢
With us today, we have the Undersecretary, Mr. Yao Sing Mu, and his colleagues, representatives from the Highways Department, and Mr. Peter Lau, Director of Highways. And from the MTRCL, we have Dr. Philip Wong and Ms. Maggie So. As we have quite a crammed agenda today, so when we invite the Undersecretary to give an opening statement, we will also be asking the MTRCL to do a PowerPoint presentation. So over to you, Undersecretary. Please be brief and concise. Yes, in March this year, we have already submitted papers to this subcommittee reporting to members the progress of data of the construction of the Sha Tin Central Link up until the end of December. Now we're reporting to you the progress as at the 31st of March 2015. Well, all the contracts for the SCL have been awarded and works have already commissioned. And we will be asking the MTRCL to give you a PowerPoint presentation to give you all the updates. And let me first talk about a few points that would affect the progress. Earlier on, with regard to the archaeological finds at Tokwa 1, there were delays to the works, and the Antiquities Authority, after taking into account views expressed to it on the 8th of December 2014, already came up with a decision on the archaeological preservation package. So most of the archaeological discoveries or remains or remnants will be preserved in situ. So they will have to be protected by backfilling of protective materials. And we expect that everything will be completed within this month. With regard to the J2 well and also the water channel within the Tokwa 1 station under the AMO, all the details have been recorded. With regard to their conditions, and also in March this year, they've already completed the removal by hand, and they would also be kept intact very properly. And with regard to Tokwa 1 station, starting from March this year, works have already started full steam. And as at the end of March this year, the MTRCL expected that the additional works would cause a delay by some 11 months, and there will be at least some $4.1 billion additional cost, and the Highways Department will continue to monitor the progress of the SCL, and we expect that the MTRCL would implement delay recovery measures so that we will be able to commission the service on schedule. With regard to the exhibition station, we have to set aside land for the construction of the new complex. So with regard to the completion date for that, we expect that there will be at least a 5-month delay. And also to tie in with the CEDD's WDII or WD2 and also the Central Wan Chai Bypass water works, we believe that the site would only be handed back to the SCL's contractor in 6 months. That's why we expect that for the Hong Kong to Admiralty section that will only be commissioned in 2022. And concerning the Central Wenchai Reclamation Phase 2, which has been announced recently, with regard to the old Wenchai Pier, a large number of metals were found, and the CEDD is now conducting investigation works, and according to WDI2, the new reclamation site by December next year will have to be handed over to the contractor of the SCL in order to construct the temporary transport or traffic diversion scheme related to the SCL, as the materials will affect the reclamation works and the handover date of the work site might be delayed. Therefore, the Highways Department and the MTRCL will continue to monitor closely the investigation works of the metal that has been found to determine if the Hong Kong section of the SCL would be further delayed. The MTRCL is now looking at the overall cost of the SCL, and as the SCL's contingency fund would not be able to cope with the additional costs arising from the archaeological finds and so on, so we'll be working with the Development Bureau so that we will seek additional funding from this council in order to implement the works. So I'll now defer to the MTRCL, which will report to you the progress of the SCL. Yes, Mr. Dr. Wong. Yes, I'd like to defer to my colleague Aidan Rooney, who will give you more details about the progress of the SCL.
Chairman and members, today I'm going to report the progress of the SCL as of the end of March 2015. This is the map showing the alignment of SCL. I believe all of you should be familiar with it. Let's skip to the construction progress directly. The construction of SCL commenced in mid-2012. It comprises of six sections according to the geographical locations from north to south. Let's see the construction works of the train stations under the Sha Tin to Wong Tai Sin section. The works for Hin Kiang Station are progressing well. The structural works were substantially complete by the end of April. Electrical, mechanical and fitting out works have now commenced, and the works are progressing to program. For the extension of the Diamond Hill Station, the excavation and supporting works will be completed in May. Construction of the station structure is now ongoing in phases. The platform construction of the Kai Tak Station was completed, while the structural works of the station concourse is now ongoing and will be substantially complete in June. For the tunnelling works, the drill and blast works for the tunnel section between Hin Kiang and Ma Chai Hang have commenced since July last year. Because of the complicated geological condition, extra time has been needed to stabilise the strata. Therefore, the progress is slower than expected. As of the end of March this year, the tunnelling works were around 2 to 3 months behind schedule, and that delay has been held in the month of April. The two tunnels from Diamond Hill to Ma Chai Hang and Kai Tak to Diamond Hill are constructed by tunnel boring machines, which are called Nuwa and Mu Guayin, respectively. For Mu Guayin, she has already completed the uptrack tunnel from Kai Tak to Diamond Hill in mid-March and is planning to start the downtrack tunnel construction again from Kai Tak in August. While for Nuwa, it is expected that the uptrack tunnel will be completed in June this year. As for the Kowloon City section, the government decided on the conservation options in December last year, with most of the archaeological options to be preserved in situ. The conservation requires revisions to the shaft and station design, and also the work procedures. The relevant works have contributed to a delay of at least 11 months and an additional cost of approximately 4.1 billion Hong Kong dollars. Due to the heritage preservation, there are extra piling works for the change of the shaft and station layout. The piling works commenced right after confirmation of the conservation plan and were completed in April. Excavation works have all commenced at the east end of the station. For the tunnel section from Tokowan to Homantin Station, the assembling works of the tunnel boring machine Princess Wencheng have been completed, and the boring works started in mid-April this year and are progressing currently to plan. The roof slab construction of the west of Matawai Station was completed in April this year. The roof slab construction at the east is now in progress. It's expected that the whole roof slab construction will be completed by the end of this year. The works are approximately 5 months behind schedule. We've already rearranged the works procedures and deployed additional equipment and staff in order to catch up with the programme. As for Hung Hom section, the shifting of the multiple traffic lanes of Chatham Road North was completed in December last year. Tunnel excavation works are now progressing and are generally on schedule. Diaphragm wall and foundation works are ongoing at Hung Hom Station. Station modification works are also underway. The progress is approximately 3 months behind schedule. We've already adjusted work procedures to catch up with the programme, while structural works are now underway at the Hung Hom freight yard. As for the Cross Harbour and Hong Kong Island section, as we announced before, some of the critical sites under the Wan Chai Central Bypass and Wan Chai Development Phase 2 will be available and handed over to SCL 6 months behind the original schedule. To facilitate the construction of the exhibition station, the existing public transport interchange at Wan Chai Ferry Pier will be located to a new reclaimed site. Chairman and members, I would like to just confirm that we actually opened the new PTI on Sunday, and the actual traffic movements yesterday were in accordance with the plan, and so far no extra delay at that location. Site formation is now in progress at the existing Sheko Quarry to provide the casting yard for the immersed tube units. Besides the construction of new railway sections, improvement works are also ongoing for the operating railway facilities. To avoid interrupting normal train service, most of the works could only be carried out overnight after normal hours of train services. For example, platform strengthening and signalling equipment works for the East Rail Line are now in progress in order to facilitate the future APG retrofitting works. To cater for the eight-car train operation of the East-West Corridor, platform extension works are also carried out at stations along MOL, and most of the works have been completed, while modification works for lifts, escalators and station facilities are continuing at Diamond Hill. In conclusion, as of the end of March this year, the overall works for the SCL were 31% completed compared to the planned completion of 39%. Chairman and members, please note that the updated figures at the end of April were 33% completed compared to a planned completion of 40%. As affected by the archaeological works, there is at least 11 months delay to the Tai Wai and Hung Hom section. We will constantly review and progress of the project, develop mitigation measures, and coordinate with the relevant authorities with a view to commissioning the Tai Wai to Hung Hom section in 2019 as far as possible. For Hung Hom to Admiralty section, the works need to allow flexibility for the topside development. For the convention centre at Exhibition Station, and to cater for the reclamation works under Wan Chai Development Phase 2 and the tunnel works for the central Wan Chai bypass. There is also an expected late site handover by other infrastructure projects in the vicinity. It is estimated that there will be at least 6 months delay to the original programme, with target opening very likely to be deferred to 2021. We will continue to liaise closely with the concerned parties to mitigate such delays as far as possible. Chairman, thank you.
Okay, thank you. All right, then.
Now the floor is given to members. For those who have indicated that they wish to ask are Gary Fan, Wong Kwok-Hing, Claudia MO, Chen Kam Lam, and me. Anyone else? Mr. Xia Weiqun. Gary Fan, 4 minutes. Now, we are given a paper today from paragraph 6 to 22. It's mainly, well, I have questions about Tokwa 1 station archaeological works. I think not enough effort has been made. Well, I think for the conservation of monuments, yes, that has to be paid for by public money. And if further funding will be sought from LACHCO, I will support that. However, for the SIL delay, it seems that it's all because of Tokwa 1 station. But we know that there's Hin King, Tokwa 1, etc. There are numerous stations on the way. And you have explained to us that there are numerous challenges and problems. So it's not just about the conservation of the Tokwa 1 archaeological site. That is not the only reason for the delay. So I would like to ask you this question, government. At this stage, how are you going to judge which station's delay is not connected to the discovery of the archaeological site, and MTRCL has to shoulder the responsibility, and that budget of course should not be borne by the government, it should be borne by the MTRCL, and which part should be paid for by public money? Has the government made any judgment so far? And if you have, would MTRCL be willing to shoulder the responsibility? Well, because there may be management problems or construction problems, so there are so many delays, and that's why they are overspending. And in the record, it shows that last year, the MTRCL said that they were sorry about the delay, and the delay cost would be fully borne by the company, and that was your CEO, Mr. Waters, said. With regard to Mr. Gary Fenn's question, point number one, just now MTRCL said that other than the archaeological site at Tokwa 1, yes, it has indeed caused significant delay, at least 11 months. And just now we also said that on other sections, there were other issues, and that's why delays were caused. As for the reasons for such delays, who should be held responsible, I'll ask the MTRCL to supplement. Undersecretary, can you answer for the government? Has you made a judgment? You shouldn't ask MTRCL to make its own decision. Well, for XRL, you have trust the MTRCL too much, and so that's why there are so many problems. The government should have its own judgment. Undersecretary, Mr. Fan asked two questions. Well, for the SIL, we are using an entrustment approach. So MTRCL is the manager of this project, so they would know all the things more clearly. And while we monitor the progress, they also have their own perspective. So I would like to ask the MTRCL to answer first. Thank you, Chairman. On several work fronts, there are delays, and in the report, we have told you at Ma Chai Hang to Sha Tin. Now we are doing blasting. There is a delay because there are faults there. So there are geological problems. These are unexpected problems, and we are now trying our best to recover the time. Members, please make sure that you leave enough time for the administration and the MTRCL to answer the questions. Mr. Wong Kwok Hing. For the report just now, I'm surprised by a delay. That is for SIL. It will be commissioned only in 2021.
1. We are now in 2015. So it's 7 years from now. I think this is a huge regret. So I would like to ask the government, are there ways, are there possibilities that you will be able to commission the SIL before 2021? For SIL, yes, I know there is this archaeological discovery, so that's why you have an unexpected delay. For example, old wells at Song Wong Toi and at Wan Chai by the harbour front, you lately have discovered a sunken warship. So these were all unexpected. However, you should recover the delay, and this is most urgent. Just now, when I heard the MTRCL report, they say that for the PTI there, it's already commissioned. So my question is it possible to advance the whole program, that is commissioning before 2021? With regard to Mr. Wong's questions, I would like to give you some facts as outlined in the paper. For SIL, there are two sections. One is Taiwan to Hong Kong, and the original commissioning day was October 2018. However, because of the discovery of the relics and the conservation of them, now there is a 11-month delay. So it will be commissioned in 2019. That is for SIL. There, that is the horizontal line. The target commissioning date is now 2019. As for the next section, that's the cross harbor section, Hong Kong to Admiralty. The original commissioning date was 2020 December. Now, because at the Wan Chai reclamation site, the handover date may be delayed. So in, our commissioning date will be delayed to 2021. So when compared with original target date, that's just 1 year delay. As to how the delay can be recovered, I will ask the MTRCL to answer the questions. Dr. Wong? For Mr. Wong's questions, you talked about the north-south line, and because of the Wan Chai bypass, the handover of the site will be delayed. But for the north-south line, there are several paths. There will be a new cross-harbor tunnel, and at Causeway Bay, there will be a new tunnel leading to MOT. And we will have construction works at the exhibition station. For cross-harbor tunnel and Causeway Bay to MOT tunneling, now they are on time. But for the exhibition station, because of the delay in the handover of site, so that's why we may lag behind a bit. But we are now trying to find solutions. We'll try our best to recover the time. Next, Ms. Claudia MO. For SIL, now there is a major overspending and delay. I think you are not frank enough when you explain about the delay to us. You just tell us that it's behind schedule, it's delayed. It seems that it's natural catastrophe and it's nobody's fault. And now gradually you are willing to admit that at Ma Chai Hang there are geographical, geological problems, and that's unexpected. But before the construction, you should have a geological report. So was that report problematic? And now that's a major cost overrun. Now it's $41.6 billion. It's reported in the press. And you're saying that the conservation causes major delay and contingency funds are not enough, so you have to come to LegCo to seek further funding. Well, if the cost overrun is over $40 billion, and you have chosen the cheapest conservation option. You said that you have listened to people's view, but then you have picked the cheapest option, and it's only $4 billion, so it's just one-tenth. So how much more funding will you be seeking from us? So are you asking two questions about the cost overrun of $41 billion and the conservation project? Well, I would like to explain further. Yes, there are reports saying that the cost overrun will be $41 billion, but that's not accurate. And there are no grounds for it. In 2011 to 2012, we came to LegCo for the cost estimate, and it's $79.8 billion MOD prices. And now, because of archaeological reasons, the cost may increase by $4.1 billion. Because at that time, we didn't know there might be an archaeological discovery. So it's increased by $4.1 billion because of this. In the future, if we need to seek further funding, of course, this is what we will have to take into account. Because it's not just about the construction of railway, it also involves conservation. So when we come for funding, we will join hands with the Development Bureau to do so. Chairman, I hope he can answer me directly. Well, you say that is reported in a newspaper, and it says that there's a cost overrun of $41 billion, and that's wrong. So what exactly is the cost overrun? And you will be coming to LegCo for more funding, and how much would that be? Chairman, I made it very clear just now. When we came to LegCo for funding, we asked for $79.8 billion MOD. And just now, my colleagues have also explained that because of the archaeological site at Tokwa Wan, well, he's repeating himself. Please be succinct. Cost overrun, how much? How much do you want to get from the LegCo? Well, they will definitely come. We will ask for a sum of money that's not already included in our original budget. And how much is that? We do not know the accurate answer right now. We don't know when we will come for funding. The press might have misunderstood us. It might have taken other past assessments into account, and they thought it was part of the cost overrun. In the initial stage, we made some assessment, and the newspaper thought that the government has already asked for that money. But actually, at that time, we just asked for $79.8 billion. Okay, they are saying that they don't know when they will come, and they don't know how much the sum will be. Okay, second round, please, Ms. Mo. Mr. Chen Kam Lam. Chairman, for this project, I don't think it's a simple project. And it will not be completed within a short time. And there are dozens of contracts. Some of the contracts might not have started yet. So now you're asking him for the exact figure of cost overrun. I don't think they can tell you. I'm most concerned about this part. That is, in the past, there were other railway projects, well, similar railway projects, and there were delays and cost overruns. So I hope the MTRCL and the government can be frank. I think this is very important. No matter when delays occur, they should let the public know as soon as possible.
So they should come early and let us know so that on the one hand, the administration can step up monitoring, and on the other hand, the public can be informed of the latest progress. So what I'd like to know is, what we are talking about is the metal found in Wenchai. All right, Undersecretary, you did not tell us exactly what it was, and whether you have already decided whether it would be salvaged and excavated, and if it's to be excavated, of course, we all thought that it might have been the relics of a warship. And as far as Hong Kong is concerned, it's also part of our history. So how are we going to record that part of history is something that we are all concerned about. So I'd like to know whether the administration has already decided on what is going to be done and what are the arrangements in the future. Sorry, Chairman. Well, in Wenchai, a metal object was found. This is a large metal object. And since this is within the worksite of the CEDD, well, according to their initial understanding and estimate, it might have to do with the relic of a sunken ship. But then as to the nature of that, I'm sure the department is now working with some experts and they are conducting some investigation. So we don't know the latest situation, but then I'm sure once they get hold of the situation, I'm sure they would give an account to the public. Well, this object has been found for quite a while. So are you now doing excavation work? And what is the progress? And when will the administration be able to tell exactly what it is and how it should be dealt with? So within a short space of time, I'm sure you should be able to come to a decision. So can you tell us the progress or schedule? So do you have a schedule in mind? Well, Chairman, we are also very concerned about this, and we also take that very seriously because this part of the works would have implications on the progress of the overall SCL. That's why, as far as possible, we hope that the CEDD will be able to complete their work as soon as possible so as to identify whether it's some a particular object and the condition of it, whether or not it can be removed or how it can be dealt with. And in dealing with it, the worksite can be vacated as soon as possible so that we can progress with our works. So we've already given them our view and we have already talked to the CEDD. I'm sure they are still working on it. So as soon as they know the situation, I'm sure they will report to the public. Next is my turn. Well, initially, when we found the shaft and also the relic, we were quite surprised and we were also quite happy because we were happy because we found that there were historical relics found in Hong Kong. But then we were also concerned because the figures were simply quite surprising because we are going to spend some $4.1 billion with an additional year's delay. And now we found an additional metal object. And again, we are pleased and we are also somewhat concerned. So in answering the earlier questions, you did not tell us exactly whether you'll be spending another 11 months to excavate the object and how that would be dealt with. So do you have a detailed timetable as to how you're going to deal with that? And also the SCL from Hong Kong to Admiralty. Well, this section is closely interlinked. So when compared to, well, because of other projects, the progress has been delayed and you're expecting that you can only commission it in 2021. So there'll be a year's delay. If that should continue and if other projects are not completed on time, so much so that they are not able to hand over the work sites in time, so for the original estimates, you are adding $4.1 billion as conservation cost, and with the excavation of the metal object, the cost is still unknown. So overall speaking, you may be talking about over $100 billion for the project. So is there any way that you can control the cost so that All right, you would not be telling us that, all right, we have identified or discovered an object, and therefore that would delay the project by a year, and here and there, there would be delays of a year after year. So can you tell us what you're going to do? Well, what you said was totally unforeseen in planning the project. You talk about the well that was found in Toka 1 and other relics. And it's also like this metal object, because for this particular metal object, as the relevant department has not been able to determine the nature of it. And the strings of the metal is still to be determined. So before we can move it or deal with it, I'm sure the department will have to conduct very detailed study, because if you just haphazardly remove it, let's say that it has a very important historical value, then if you cause any damage to it, I don't think that would be something that the community at large would like to see. So we will have to strike a balance. And then because of the excavation work and also the disposal of it might take some time. Yes, some extra time might be required, and as a result of that, it's not just this project. In fact, the CEDD is also undertaking other projects, so there might be delays in these projects, and the cost might also go up. But then I'm sure this is precisely what the society as a whole will have to decide. So do we want to press ahead with the project? And also, what about a heritage preservation? How do we strike a balance? I'm sure for the Tokwa 1 section of SCL, this is something that we will have to consider. But then we simply cannot wait forever. So do you have a timetable as to how long we have to wait? We don't have to wait for 11 months for the well preservation. So can you have a better timetable? As I just explained, Chairman, well, as the CEDD is now looking into this, and it is also working on it, I'm sure once a package is available, it will report to the public. Next, Tony Chair. Thank you, Chairman. Of course, this is a massive project, and it's also very complicated, involving a lot of underground works. Very often, there are unforeseen factors arising, which would result in delays or adjustments to the schedule. Well, this is very common. And very often in the design and in the formulation of the timetable or work schedule, whether it's the government or the MTRCL, in terms of how the timetable can be adhered to, I'm sure you would have some leeway for these unforeseen circumstances. If not, then the schedule of the entire project, if I remember it correctly, all right, you started work in 2012. And now, basically, it's been 2 years or slightly more than 2 years into the works, and there are delays now. And of course, I hope that you would try your best to see if you can recover some of the delays in order to minimize the impact on the commissioning date. And as far as we are concerned, Chairman, we would be watching closely the progress. We hope that we would at least be informed. But then I'm kind of worried, because, Chairman, there are many railway lines that are being built, including the XRL. So in terms of government's monitoring recently, I think many colleagues are of the view that they are pretty worried. So are we able to monitor the MTRCL, because it is the expert? So maybe the government can also tell us so that we can be reassured. And also in the PowerPoint presentation, you talk about the SCL, the overall progress, 31%. So I'd like to know, so what is the basis for such percentage? I'm sure when you came up with the overall work schedule and the milestones, so you must be looking at the workload or the payment that has been made, and also the time that has been spent. All right, we have already worked so far, so we have already gone through about 31% of the total workflow. Is that the case? So I'd like to know the basis for this calculation. How did you come up with this 31% completed? Well, I'll defer to the MTLCO. Concerning the first point, whether or not you have planned for some leeways for the progress of the works. And second, with regard to the 31% completed, what is the basis for this figure? And then after they have answered, I'll defer to the Director for Highways to tell you more about progress monitoring. Yes? Well, for every project under individual works contract, the overall progress in different types of works, there would be different time given. In some cases, there would not, because if you look at the overall project, for example, if it takes 60 months to complete, and then for the critical parts, there might be some leeway, others not. And also, you ask about the progress in terms of percentage. In fact, initially, when the works started, for example, if there are 15 contracts along the alignment, then they would be distributed and given a weighting. So after a weighting is given, then we would look at the actual completion rate. For example, how many concrete has been put in, and also what is the length of a tunnel being dug. Then we would calculate the percentage. So we do not just look at the cost. Yes, Mr. Lau? Please be brief. Yes, Chairman. Just very briefly, as far as the SCL is concerned, we also have this monitoring and verification system, and under this, we have also hired consultants to help us. And after multiple meetings, well, at the contract level and at the works level, we would understand the progress, and the MTLCL would also be required to submit monthly report to us, and through this monitoring mechanism, we would also be checking the reports to see if it's able to reflect very truthfully the progress on the ground. Second round, Gary Fan, Claudia Mo. Anyone else asking in the second round? If not, then I'll draw a line. 3 minutes. Gary Fan, thank you, Chairman. Well, I would still like to put this to the Undersecretary, because Para 25 says that, well, in Wenchai, you have discovered a large metal object. That's why there would be a delay of handing over the site to the contractor, and that would lead to further delays. Earlier on, because of the Central Wenchai Bypass, there was also a delay in the handing over of the work site, and as a result, the schedule has also been delayed. So in terms of the system, we'll have learning from the experience of SCL and also the XRL. So for the five lines to be built by the MTRCL, apparently there are delays for all. So at this stage, in implementing these infrastructure works, in particular railway projects, you are having one after one, and you're actually stretching the manpower very thinly. And also the MTRCL, in terms of its management, there might also be technical problems, and as a result, you might not be able to complete the works on time. So how is the administration going to learn from the experience? Have you reviewed this so that in planning for future projects, you would avoid implementing different major infrastructure projects simultaneously? Undersecretary. Chairman, during the past months and years, both the government and the MTRCL, in implementing the five railway projects, we have encountered different circumstances. In some cases, in particular, when it's about carrying out works underground, sometimes we might encounter conditions which we might not have foreseen in the investigation phase. But then can you answer my question directly, because I don't have a lot of time. Have you reviewed that? I'm not asking you to explain that for individual lines there are problems, but then now that five lines have experienced delays, what are you going to do to avoid that from happening again? And if you haven't done that, then just tell us. Well, Mr. Fan, it's not a simple question or a simple answer of yes or no, because I'd just like to say that for some delays, well, it cannot be foreseen, because I was trying to explain why. Because, for example, for the archaeological finds, that could not have been foreseen. And then in some cases, for example, if it's about the schedule of the works, for example, at this juncture, all right, the labor market is pretty tight. And therefore, in future, if we were to implement certain projects, we would also have to take a close look at the labor market and the supply and demand situation, because, well, past experience would enable us to think about it more carefully in future projects. And also because of this, well, in the XRL project, the government has already engaged independent experts to consider the issue, and the experience given to us was very important. We would learn from the experience in implementing future works and projects.
Next, Ms. Claudia MO. Thank you, Chairman. About the delay, they have told us very clearly that the SCL is divided into two parts, and Highway to Hong Kong 11 months delay, and it will be commissioned in 2019. As for cross harbor section, there will be another year's delay. Originally it's 2020, now it's 2021. Now you made it very clear. Then I cannot understand how come they cannot give me a rough sum, that is the cost overrun, and how much more money will you be needing for these extra works, and when will that application come? Well, you should be telling us how come you're dragging your feet, or is just $4.1 billion for the conservation? Undersecretary, Chairman, just now Ms. Mo asked this question from her angle. Of course, she hopes to know about all these as soon as possible. That is, how much more money do we want? Yes, I can understand her. However, in my explanation just now, I've already said that for the SCL and for its critical works delay, it's mainly connected to the archaeological works, and now that's an extra cost of $4.1 billion. At this stage, we are making assessments on all fronts, so that's why I cannot tell you an exact figure now. This is the major reason. We haven't finished our work yet. After doing all this calculation and assessments, we will come back to LegCo for the application of funding. And so when we will do that, we will have to look at our cash flow, and then we will make a judgment. If possible, we would do that within this week, but within this year. But I really cannot tell you the exact time right now. So for that $4.1 billion, it's just about the Tau Kwa Wan archaeological sites conservation. And you definitely need that $4.1 billion from us. Now for the archaeological part, well, just say yes or no. Don't repeat yourself. I want to explain, because that was not included in the original budget. And now we need an extra sum of money for conservation. So that's why we need that amount of money. So the answer is yes. Okay, I'm satisfied. Okay, second round. Just now I asked the Undersecretary about the large metal object. We don't know whether it's a ship or what. Undersecretary says that the CED is now doing the work. So will you ask the CED to carry out the work to a certain extent and then report to you? What's the monitoring process? Chairman, for the Wan Chai Development Phase 2 is a CED project, so it has to carry out its own work. It's a works project. So they are subject to their own monitoring process. They are also very concerned about the progress. For that metal object, if it's not handled properly, then at its location, it will affect their project. It will also affect our railway projects and other road projects. So they are very concerned about the handling of the object. But when we look at the whole issue, that is, whether that metal object can be removed to another place, they have to make very careful calculation. And when they know the situation clearer, they will definitely explain to the public as to how the metal subject will be handled. Now, if the metal subject is to be conserved, will it be conserved? And if it is conserved, will it affect their projects and other related projects? They will have to look at all this. Well, we are all very concerned, Under Secretary, because all these projects are interconnected. If they cannot hand over the sites, then our railway will be delayed further. And Hong Kong people are paying for the construction of this railway. And Hong Kong Wanchai Bypass is also paid by Hong Kong people. So we hope the government would do things carefully, no matter it's about archaeological excavation or you are going to move the object elsewhere. You have to have a timetable. Under Secretary, do you have the timetable today? How come you cannot give us a timetable? Do you have a plan? Or do you have an interdepartmental working group on this? We want to know what will happen to the object. Will there be a major delay? Can the Undersecretary tell us what you are doing now? Chairman, you raised your concern, and I believe it's not just your concern, it's also the concern of society. We are aware of that. So we are talking to the CEDD, the Development Bureau, about this, and I'm sure they know that this part will have a major impact on a number of projects. So once they clarify the situation and make a decision, they will explain to the public. Okay. Let's end the discussion of this item. We'll move on to the next item. That is a progress update of the construction of the West Island Line, South Island Line, and Kwun Tong Line extension. The paper has been given to members. So, Under Secretary, can you take us through the paper, and then we'll ask MTRCL to do the PowerPoint presentation. Chairman, in March this year, we provided a paper to the Subcommittee on Matters Relating to Railways. We talked about the West Island Line, South Island Line, as well as the Kwun Tong Line extension. And today we are going to provide another update report for the Subcommittee, and it's the progress up to the end of the 31st of March 2015. As for the Kennedy Town Station and Hong Kong U Station, they were commissioned on the 31st of December last year. As for Sai Ying Kun Station, is commissioned on the 29th of March this year, other than Killing Lane. And these three stations are open for use by the public. They are providing services for the residents and workers along the line. This is a very convenient choice for them. The MTRCL expects that for the Killing Lane exit, it can be commissioned in the fourth quarter of this year. As for the WIL station, some parts of it has seen a water seepage recently, and they are at passenger exits, lift lobbies, or station platforms. We are very concerned about the water seepage issue, and the MTRCL has started remedying. The relevant government departments have also conducted site inspections at the stations and passenger adders. They discovered that the seepages occurred only at localized areas and the situation was not serious. Similar situations also occurred previously at some underground structures. The preliminary view is that the seepage should not affect the structural integrity of the stations nor the railway operation. Later on, Buildings Department and EMSD arranged site inspections at the railway tunnel to see if similar seepage situation occurs. But the situation was not serious either. So the structures and operations would not be affected. We have asked the MTRCL to conduct a detailed investigation, and they will be carrying out remedial works. As for the SILE, its targeted commissioning date is still end of 2016. As for the underpinning works, they are still an important part of the project, and now the excavation works are carried out smoothly, and it's expected to end at June this year. And this delay causes delays in other structures. So to meet the target date, we have to improve efficiency on all fronts so that the whole progress can be sped up. The Highway Department will continue to monitor closely these works. As for KTE, the MTLCL's target commissioning date is mid-2016. As for the platform tunnel at Wangpo Station, is not completed yet, and also there are geological problems on the ground. According to the information of the Highways Department, if this tunnel cannot be completed in the second quarter of this year, then for the target commissioning date of mid-2016 will be affected. We will continue to monitor the progress of the project because there are unexpected challenges. So MTLCL has explained to us that they will continue to review the cost of the construction of the SIL and the KTE, and that they may need an upward adjustment. And because they are ownership projects, the MTLCL will shoulder the relevant extra costs. And according to the latest estimation of the MTLCL, the major infrastructure of the SILE, for example, the PTI at Wang Chuk Hang and the improvement roadworks in the vicinity of Ocean Park Station, etc., all of this may cost a cost overrun of $160 million. The MTLCL will continue to monitor the situation and provide the most updated information. Now I ask the MTLCL to do the PowerPoint presentation. I'll ask my colleague, who is responsible for the WIL and SILE, to give a presentation. Mark Wisner, please.
Good morning, Chairman and Member of the Committee. I'll give you an update on the West Island Line project. So West Island Line is a 3 kilometre long extension to the existing island line stretching from Shun Wan Station to Kennedy Town Station, with 2 intermediate stations at Sai Ying Pung and HKU. The journey time from Shun Wan Station to Kennedy Town Station is about 7 minutes. Following the opening of Kennedy Town Station and HKU stations on the 28th of December last year, Sai Ying Pung Station commenced passenger service on the 29th of March this year. Sai Ying Pung has a total of 6 entrances. Got entrances at Queens Road West, Davao Road West, First Street, Second Street and Bonham Road, and these were opened and have commenced service. The entrance at Keeling Lane is targeted to open in the fourth quarter of 2015. Structural works for the Keeling Lane entrance is still ongoing. The ground freezing is underway at the remaining 20-metre passenger adit that connects the entrances of First Street and Second Street to facilitate the subsequent excavation and tunnel lining construction. As the Keeling Lane entrance is still under construction, a temporary wall has been erected at the B1-B2 entrance to separate the passengers from the construction site. With the commencement of Sai Ying Pung service, the train frequency between Kennedy Town Station and Chai Wan Station remains the same as the arrangement before opening, approximately 2-minute headway during peak hours and 4-minute headway during weekday non-peak hours. The Island Line service was extended to Western District with the opening of the 3 new services, and to cater for the growing passenger demand, the Island Line train service has been progressively enhanced with 63 additional trips per week. Similar to previous new railway projects, teething problems will be encountered and some fine-tuning adjustments and rectifications are required during the initial operating period. The Corporation has closely monitored the performance of train service and station facilities to make necessary enhancements while also minimising any inconvenience caused to passengers. Enhancement actions based on passenger feedback include the increased ventilation at entrance A adit of HKU station and the adjustment of the new 3-in-1 ticket machines for better convenience to the passengers. Sai-in-Pung and HKU stations are both deep underground stations constructed below the groundwater table. The design included features to prevent water from entering within the structure. However, it is still necessary to carry out some further grouting works to seal up leaks that may occur after construction is completed, and such works take time. This is not unusual compared to other deep underground structures in Hong Kong. Minor seepage of water will not have any adverse effect on the structural integrity of the stations, and water dripping areas, once found, are immediately sheltered off or fenced off to ensure passengers and train service are not affected. To minimise the inconvenience caused to passengers, station cleaning is enhanced and station staff are arranged to assist passengers. Thank you.
Next, Mr. Chow. Dr. Wong, who is going to do the presentation?
Update on SIL. So SIL is a medium capacity railway operated with three car trains. Extends from Admiralty Station to Southern District and interchanges with the Island Line and Chun Wan Line at Admiralty. The railway has a 7-kilometre route alignment with five stations. As of the 31st of March this year, the project is about 85% complete. So starting from the southern end of the railway, the structural works for South Horizons and Leitung stations are in progress, and platform construction for both these stations has been completed. At Leitung station, the structural works at entrance A on Aplichau Main Street have been completed, and the associated passenger adit has also been completed. The construction work at entrance B, the deep shaft entrance at Leitung Estate, is taking longer than anticipated due to unforeseen adverse ground conditions. The completion of the entrance structure and fitting out works, as well as the installation of passenger lifts, is expected to continue for this entrance into the first half of 2016. However, the station will still be ready for the overall opening of SIL, which is targeted by the end of 2016. For Ocean Park and Wong Chuk Hang stations, the structural works have been completed and the E&M fitting out works are well advanced. With trackside works completed in the section from Ocean Park Station to South Horizon Station, low-speed dynamic testing of the new SIL trains has commenced between Wong Chuk Hang and South Horizon Station. As for Wong Chuk Hang Depot, fitting out works for the E&M and architectural works is substantially complete, and four of the SIL trains have been delivered to the depot as of the end of March. At Nam Phung Tunnel, the lining works and the construction of the transition structure that connects to the viaduct section are substantially complete. Track construction has been in progress in the tunnel since the end of last year. At Admiralty Station, excavation is continuing at the eastern end of the Island Line underpinning zone, with the western and central sections now at foundation level. Cut and cover excavation is substantially complete and construction of the station structures is now in progress with parts of the higher level structures completed. The Island Line underpinning works at Admiralty Station remain the most critical part of the SIL project. Safety continues to be maintained as the top priority for these works. The monthly excavation progress has improved since November last year, although the existing delay could not be recovered. To conclude, with the exception of Leitung Station Entrance B at Leitung Estate, the construction of the four new stations and their entrances in the Southern District is generally in line with the original programme. Challenges remain for Admiralty Station underpinning works and the construction progress at the station is still behind. Nevertheless, the target for opening of SIL is still at the end of 2016. The updated SIL completion and opening date can only be confirmed at completing the underpinning works and securing sufficient manpower for the civil works. We will continue to report to the subcommittee regarding the progress of the project. Thank you.
Thank you. Next, Mr. Chow. Chairman, members, I'll be reporting the progress of the KTE. Well, the KTE is an extension of the existing line from Yamate to Wangpo, and there'll be a Homantin station in between, and Homantin station will also form part of the interchange station in the future. And for the KTE, it started in middle of 2011, and up until end of March 2015, the overall completion rate is 75.6%. This is a picture from Chatham Road North, looking at Homantin Station work site, and we are building the structure of the station. And up until the end of March, we have already completed 88% of that. And surrounding the work site, we have already started the piping and also connection of cables and electrical wires. So this is the Homantin Station, the existing situation. And then on the top left and top right is from Chung Hau Street, looking at overlooking Homantin, and also for part of the structure is already nearing completion. And for the overall station structure, we expect that in the second quarter we'll be paving the roof. And then the lower pictures would be within the Homantin station is the SCL platform and also the Kuntong Line platform. We are now doing the building services and also the installation of equipment and so on. And for EMS facilities, we are now installing the escalators and also the cooling system and also the platform screen doors. And what is more challenging would be the EMS and also civil engineering and also the track laying and the interfacing and also the connection work, because the work sites are entrance constrained because we'll be paving the roof. So much of the equipment can only be carried out can only be carried by the train to the platform. Other than the work trains from Yamate to Huangpo, the tunneling work is more or less completed, and we are now pressing ahead with the track laying works, and we expect that all the tracks can be laid all the way to Huangpo station by the middle of 2015. Other than Homantin Station and its construction, we also have EPIW near Homantin Station, which will connect with the housing estates nearby and the communities, including pedestrian footbridges and also access and also lifts. Up until the end of March this year, the overall pedestrian facilities have completed some 72%. And these pictures show the EPIWs. Well, top left is the covered pedestrian footbridge crossing over Chatham Road North. It's partially opened this year, and we are now completing the cover and also the escalator. And top right and bottom right, these are the footbridges connecting Oyman Estate and also Sheung Lok Street. We are doing the structural works and also the fitting out works. And bottom left is Chung Hau Street PTI. Basically, the platform structure is completed, and that would also tie in with the Homantin Station's commissioning. It will be open to the public. As we have said during the past few reports, for the Huangpo Station, well, is one of the main challenges along the KTE, and up until end of March this year, in terms of the tunneling work, we have completed 39% when compared to the original plan, 45%, so we are lagging behind by 6%. And also for the platform tunnel, starting from end of last year, we worked round the clock. And early this year, we received some noise complaints and vibration complaints from residents. That's why, starting from mid-February, for the tunneling work, we can only work till 11 p.m. every night. And then for this tunnel, well, we work both from the eastern end and the western end. So we work towards the center, so the excavation works. Well, in the middle of this year, we hope to be able to complete that. But then as the work hours restrictions, there are still some risks. And also for the Western and Eastern Concourse, there are some problems, but then we expect to be able to complete that in the third quarter. So the structure works will be completed, and we will be starting with the reinstatement of the road surface. This is the Western Concourse in Wanpo Station, beneath Hong Kong Road and also Tek Man Road. This is the junction. And we also have a very complicated traffic diversion scheme before we can have enough space for us to press ahead with the works. And as I said before, we have already started the backfilling package. So for the pipes repaving work, we will start that in the third quarter this year. With regard to the Eastern Concourse of Wanpo Station, it's like the Western Concourse. It's at the junction, and we have now got the cut and cover package, so it's decked over, and then we are pressing ahead with the works underground, and the target is the third quarter of this year so that the structure works will be completed. And also within the station, the works, as you can see here, well, that's the latest situation in the East and West Concourse. So top two pictures are the so we have already started the main support works, and then below are the tunneling works. And for the West Concourse, we are actually having this concrete and soil structure, so we are doing the drilling and digging. And for the West Concourse, we are doing the tunnel boring work. So overall speaking, for the KTE, we are working full steam to press ahead with the works, and we are facing a lot of challenges. And as we have said, well, for the Huangpo Concourse Tunnel, that's the critical point of the entire line. So for the tunneling work on the platform, we are still faced with unstable ground conditions and also limited space for works, and also the challenge posed by limited working hours. So we will have to wait until the tunnel can achieve some significant progress before we can be sure about the commissioning date and arrangement. And our target date of commissioning our service is still middle of 2016. Thank you. All right. The floor is now open to members' questions. I'll read out the names. Chen Kam Lam, Wong Kwok Heng, Priscilla Leung, Gary Fan, Chen Hang Pan, Helena Wong, Claudia Mo, anyone else? Lo Wai Kwok, 4 minutes each. Chen Kam Lam. Thank you, Chairman. Chairman, I'd like to know a bit more for Ed Lo Ti Harcourt Garden, the consolidated station, from September to December 2012, because of the Occupy movement, well, that's 2014, and you said that there were problems. And in paragraph 23 of the paper, you said that during the closure period, when compared to the SIL's overall construction period, it's just a very brief period. But of course, you're talking about 79 days of closure when compared to several years of works period. Then of course, you would describe it as brief. But then it doesn't mean that there has been no impact whatsoever. But then in your paper, you said that the MTRCL considers the closure of roads only has limited impact. So what did you mean? So how are you going to go after the people or those participants of the Occupy movement? MTRCL, can you explain? Thank you, Chairman. Well, given the situation on the ground beneath the Admiralty Station, the works that were underway can be divided into several parts. One is the underpinning works, and also we needed to excavate the soil and the ground, and also we would also have to carry out some concreting works. And then in terms of the impact on Central's traffic, the excavation works, well, in terms of removing the debris, there were some difficulties, but then the contractor already reflected that to the MTRCL. And then as far as other works are concerned, Well, in terms of the critical works, the most important part is the excavation of the underpinning works. We will have to drill the rocks, and that would have to be done within 24 hours. And we try our best not to affect other conditions. But then, as I said, constructively, we also had to do the concreting works, and that would also affect the construction of the structure there, and the timetable was and the timing was also affected. But then that was not the most critical part of it. So what is happening now is that the contractor has already come up with a claim, and he's of the view that because of the Occupy movement, it caused some delay to his works, but then we still haven't received the detailed claim, so I'm not in a position to provide you with the details here.
這個影響啦，咁另外咧就因為亦都有團體咧，最近呢段時間都聲稱咧喺6月中政府要通過呢個政改，要喺立法會通過投票嘅時候咧。
In the middle of June, the government or the electoral will vote on the political reform package, and there may be another Occupy movement. So are you prepared for this? Do you have any contingency plans if there will be another Occupy movement? Dr. Wong? According to last year's experience, we knew that for the ingresses and egresses of the construction sites, they are very important. Because for the delivery trucks, if they cannot reach the construction sites, the progress of the project will be affected seriously. So we have started to talk to the transport department. We are looking at road diversions plans and see if there can be mitigation measures in place if such events occurs. Mr. Wong Kwa Heng.
Thank you, Chairman. I'm an elected electoral member on the Hong Kong Island, so I'm very concerned about the Hong Kong Island transport. I would like to ask about water seepage at the WIL or along the WIL. Oh, because these are newly opened stations. And now there is water seepage problem. This is far from ideal. The government has given us some explanations, but I would like to ask more about safety. Can the MTLCL explain to us more clearly about the safety of these stations and line? This is question number one. And for SIL, the MTLCL says that the targeted commissioning date is still the end of 2016. However, they also said that for the underpinning works, they have to be completed first, and then you need enough manpower before you can decide on the commissioning date. So can you really commission the line at the end of 2016, there are still a lot of uncertainties. Just now, Mr. Chen Kam Lam said that there might be another Occupy movement and it may trigger a crisis. So I hope the MTLCL can explain to us more clearly. You talk about the end of 2016. Do you think that the SIL can really be commissioned then, Dr. Wong? Well, Sai Ying Pun Station and Hong Kong U Station, because they are dozens of meters underground and they are under the water table. So that's why they are under huge water pressure and that's why there's seepage. But this would not affect the structure of stations and operations of trains. As for station structure design, the water seepage factor has already been considered, and they have done enough concreting works to make sure that all the cracks are sealed up. Of course, in some
local areas there may be tiny problems because the tunnels tend to be long, so we still need some patch-up work. As for safety, I've told you that there will be no problem. As for your second question about SIL and the commissioning dates of 2016, as for our underpinning works, now we have completed them by 83%, so we have only 17% left. So we have quite a good chance. But after doing the underpinning works, we still need to do the concreting works. So for concreting works, it's a more labor-intensive process. We are trying our best to increase manpower. We are talking to the contractors. We hope that we can recover the delay for the structural works. Our engineering team is still targeting at commissioning by the end of 2016. For SIL, well, it's closely connected to the people living in the southern districts. They really hope that you can realize the targeted opening or commissioning date. Priscilla Leung? Well, I've heard about the Wangpo Station progress. Well, for the residents there, they are very familiar about the problems you mentioned. I think the residents there are very patient already. They have been waiting for your report. Well, you say that there are unexpected underground conditions. We have heard about that for the past few years. And now you are saying that there will be a delay, and your conclusion is that you are still facing a lot of challenges. Well, we do not want to see this. We have said this many times. Is it really a geological problem, or you are just over ambitious because you are building so many railways at the same time? You do not have enough manpower to do all these. Well, you have to be honest. Face the problem squarely. If there will be a delay, then there should be compensations. I've talked to the government. The government asked me to talk to the MTLCL. Now, if you will have a major delay, then you should provide fair discounts to the residents there. You have to answer these questions. Now, the residents hope that they can enjoy a discounted fare when you commission the railway. So by the end of 2016, you definitely have to commission the line. As for Hong Kong to MOT section, you say that there will be a delay of 6 months. We have been complaining about this because after the project had started, the ferry is cancelled, and now there will be a delay. So the traffic for that district is now problematic, and there is also noise pollution problem. Well, yeah, now you work until 11, and of course that's stopped now, but people are still unhappy. We have talked about having a ferry going to the cruise terminal. We want to see a water taxi type of service. And from Hong Kong to Central and North Point to Admiralty, can ferry services be provided before the commissioning of the railway? I have put forward a lot of ideas to the government. You can implement a number of policies so as to compensate the people living there. So how about a discount fare? MTLCL? My colleague Mr. So will answer that question. Mr. So will answer that question. Well, thank you for your opinion. Yes, we've heard that from the residents there. Each year, the MTRCL will provide discounted fares through different channels. And for Kowloon City and Wong Po, we will look at the actual situation and we will look at the future development and then we will conduct a review. Well, we do not want your discount campaigns. You are now building a major station there. You know there's serious traffic congestion and the residents are seriously affected. So you have to compensate them. This is done for compensation, not your general campaigns. Yes, we've heard Ms. Lang's opinions. Well, in other districts, you should also do that. If there's a delay, then you should compensate the residents there. Mr. Gary Fan, I have two questions. One for the Undersecretary and the other for Mr. Kushner. When I look at the paper, paragraph 19, you are saying, well, I'm worried about the wording. It's about the SILE. Well, the government earlier on talked about the XLL and the wording was similar. Here you say that MTRCL maintains that the target commissioning date of SILE is set up at the end of 2016. In order to achieve this target, MTRCL has to improve the efficiency of every aspect of the expansion and MOT station and expedite the remaining works. Highways Department will keep close monitoring of the progress of the company on such works. And the now here, what you say seems to mean that the SILE will be delayed even more, but you won't admit that till the last minute. So I would like to ask the Undersecretary, can you answer me? According to the information that you have and according to your assessment, for the SILE, how many months delay there now? And if the efficiency at MOT station cannot be improved, how much more delay? How many more months? Can you tell me the exact figure? Undersecretary, with regard to Mr. Fang's question, just now the MTRCL has already explained very clearly. The critical point is at the MOT station and the underpinning works. Well, they are still carrying out works there. They want to wait for a clearer scenario before they can decide on the commissioning date. So that's what I explained just now. There are still some risks about the targeting commissioning dates. So how many months delay now? Do you have a figure? Maybe the MTRCL can explain. Dr. Wong, maybe I can ask Mark to answer this question. Mark, please.
In terms of the progress for the SIL project, the critical area is the works at Admiralty, and we've highlighted in the paper the critical part of that particular contract is the underpinning works, and we've been carrying out the underpinning excavation since the early part of last year.
How many months delay?
As we said in the paper, the target is to complete by the end of 16, and we are still working in line with that target. We still have some uncertainty with the remaining underpinning excavation. There will still be some uncertainty in terms of securing adequate labour resources for the concreting work. But in terms of the target, we are still maintaining the end of 2016.
I'm not asking you about the target date. What's your assessment? How many months delay are there now? If you cannot recover the delay, then how many more months do you need? Because now it's already late.
Do you have the estimate?
We, in terms of the original planned opening, was the end of 2015, and we have delay according to the original plan date. But in terms of the target for the end of 2016, we are working in line with that target.
Okay, then I'll ask another question, a very simple question. And this may show that the MTRCL is very poor as management, because for the WIL, there are three stations and now there is water seepage. in the past, we didn't see this because there's a new stations. So is it a construction problem or what? You say that what you say seems to tell us that they are just teething problems. Next round, please. Now it's my turn. Now for the SILE and the future SCL, it seems there is a bottleneck, and the major problem is at MOT station. If the works at MOT station are delayed, it will have a major impact on the progress of all the other projects. The MTLCL cannot give us a concrete timetable.
Because you're still not sure about this, I believe that our 2016 commissioning would be pretty slim, but I hope that you will have to make it by 2017. And then for the island line, I can see that for the SIL, if it can be connected to Admiralty, then the entire Admiralty station will become a super interchange station. So how are you going to diverge the crowds? So it's already very crowded now, and in the future, will it be even more crowded, and how are you going to ease the overcrowdedness there? So can you tell us more? Thank you. My colleague Maggie will tell you more. Yes, thank you, Chairman. Thank you, members, for your questions. In fact, in Admiralty Station, well, for the SILE project, it would involve the expansion work in Admiralty Station, and there'll be three more underground levels. And other than the three underground levels are for the SIL and SCL, for the interchange platforms, the present island line, the Harcourt Garden part will also be expanded. In other words, the entire Admiralty Station, when it's to become a four-track station in the future, the area of the station will be expanded rather significantly. So that at different levels there would be interchange and the situation would improve. And at present, on island line for the eastern part, so that's near the plant room, and the plant room will also be relocated so that the platform and the concourse will be larger, so that in the future when there are different levels for interchange, so after you have entered the station, after the turnstile, there will be more room for the passengers. And even before entering the turnstile, there will also be more space. I understand that you're going to conduct a site visit this afternoon, and then we can also tell you on the ground as to which part will be expanded, so that when passengers interchange, they will be able to have more space. But of course, we do understand that at present, for along the northern coast of the island, the loading on the rail line is very heavy, and that will also go up further. So we'll be monitoring closely the population growth and the passenger and the patronage growth, for example, at the exit and also the escalators and so on, how they should be arranged. We will be monitoring closely. But along the entire island line, in particular for the SIL and the WIL, when they add together, I'm sure there will be it will become more crowded. So you will have to consider the arrangement for the NIL, the North Island Line. So for the several island lines, they all come to... So when are we going to have the NIL? Can you give us a very quick response? Well, the NIL... Well, under our RDS 2014, that's included. And according to our initial plan, we would not call that the top priority projects. Well, as to the timetable, I can give you later. But then for the first batch of the railways or rail lines, well, the three did not include NIL. That's what we know. But then which one is the most urgent? Helena Wong? Well, for the KTE, the commissioning date has been delayed. That's totally unacceptable. because whenever we went down to Huangpo, we can see that it has been causing a lot of nuisance and it's very crowded. And but then people have been very discreet. They have not voiced too much complaint. Well, last time you told us that it would be middle of 2016 when it would be commissioned, and now you said that it might not be feasible because every time when you come, you would always say that it's no longer feasible. So can you tell us exactly when it's going to be commissioned? Yes? You're putting this to the MTRCL? Dr. Chow, Chairman, members? As I said before, for the KTE's extension, well, the main works are on Huangpo, and the critical work would be on the platform tunnel. And then after we have completed the tunneling works, then we will have a better idea of the commissioning date. Because in the course of the tunneling works, the ground conditions, the ground conditions have been pretty challenging, and as I just said, in the end of March, we have already completed 40% of the excavation, and by end of April, we have managed to complete about 60%. And then for the remaining works, there are still some risks. That's why in my report, I said that we would have to wait until after the completion of the tunneling works before we can come up with an assessment on the commissioning date for the Huangpo station. But when will you be completing the tunneling work? Well, earlier on, we planned to work around the clock. But then because of some community vibration complaints, so instead of working around the clock, we reduced that and we reduced that to 11 p.m. So we're talking about a reduction by 8 hours. So with regard to the tunneling works at the platform, there is a delay, and our target is still to complete the tunneling by the middle of this year, and then we can press ahead with the structural works. And to a very large extent, it depends on the ground conditions, and also in the course of our works at the impact on the neighborhood, so we will have to consider these. It's already May, almost June, and if you say that you'll be completing that in mid-2015, and up until end of April, you've only completed 60%, so mid of this year, what does that mean? June or July? Our target is early August. Early August. Undersecretary, do you have anything to add? Yes, Chairman. Well, I understand that in Huangpo, many residents think that the nuisance is quite great because of the diversion of the roads. So can you supplement on the feedback of road diversion? So in fact, we can reopen the roads earlier than the completion of the works. Can you tell us more about that? Well, as we said, Chairman, well, for the structure of the station, we plan to complete that in the third quarter this year. And then, at the same time, we also plan that for the road surface and also for some pipes reinstatement, they will also be completed. So, overall speaking, in Huangpo, in the third quarter, we'll be completing the works and we'll be starting the reinstatement of the road surface. Can I tell you, can I know more about this? Because I've been there myself. All right, the road surface is now being excavated partially, so it's like cut and open, so you can look at it and it looks like a Dalmatian or a zebra. So will you be able to repave it altogether, in particular for Pt1 Street? Well, sorry, no time left. Claudia Mo, can you give us a reply in writing? Claudia Mo, well, when it comes to railway and traffic, well, for the KTE, the impact on Huangpo is very far-reaching. And even the Undersecretary was saying this. Well, if you've been to Huangpo and Hongham, just look at Wuhu Street. All right, the situation is really appalling. It's really hard to bear. And now you say that you have to work hard and fast, and originally you plan to work round the clock, but then indeed during night time the nuisance is simply too big, and therefore you are completing or ending that by 11 p.m. and that's why there will be further delays. So it's almost like a vicious circle. Apparently you're putting the blame on the resident, you complain about noise, and therefore I will stop work, and then I'll have to delay the works, and then there will be more congestion on the ground. So really, you will have to look at the road surface. The highways department will have to look at it. Well, in June, well, the entire Shin Kang Street will be closed for the road excavation, and there are a lot of schools along the road. And you said that the traffic would be diverted to Tek Teng Street. But then what about minibuses, loading and unloading, and also loading and unloading of goods? There is no replacement. So you just say that the traffic will have to be diverted there. So I can't imagine what is going to happen then. All right, originally, you just notify the residents, and then for Huangpo Garden residents were along that part. In fact, they are complaining, and you said that we can discuss that. And then according to your paper, you said that these measures along Shin Kang Street, well, it would be completely closed for several months. All right, it can be all the way up to the end of the year. Yes, of course, during the summer months, you don't have to worry too much about the school coach buses. But then you just said that in the third quarter, you should be able to complete that. So can you be more specific so that Wangpo residents do not have to worry about that day in, day out? Because it's about public hygiene too, because there are a lot of rats and pests. So this is also a hygiene problem. So can you answer the questions? Chairman, I'll defer to the MTRCL with regard to the traffic arrangement right now. And also for the reinstatement works, how would that be carried out? Mr. Chow, Lord Chairman, I'll attempt to answer the questions first. Well, in fact, the situation is like this. Well, under the plan, by the end of this year, the existing traffic diversion will be reinstated. In other words, by that we mean, well, if you've noticed it, in fact, the vehicles are not running on the road surface. They are actually running on the metal framework. So we call that a sumi-deck. So in Chinese, it's a deck. And then since it's temporary, it's not very even. And it's not very flat. And after completing the underground works, we will be backfilling it with concrete. And then we'll repave the road. So we'll be using asphalt to repave the road, so that will restore the road condition. It will become flat again. I understand members' concerns. You're concerned about the delay of the project, but then when compared to our original schedule, yes, there is a gap. But of course, we have also encountered the geological conditions which were unforeseen. And then in between the two Huangpo stations, in the connecting tunnel, we need to work around the clock underground. And then we have actually got a sumi deck at the road level, and the noise level has not exceeded the statutory limit. But then, as there is a small number of residents, they feel the ground-borne noise, the vibration. And the EPD said that after 11 p.m., we will have to stop work until 8 o'clock or 7 o'clock the next morning. So we would be losing the work hours by 35%, and as a result, the works period will be extended. Next, Lo Wai Kwok.
Thank you, Chairman. For the expansion of the Admiralty Station, one of the technical issues which has to be dealt with very carefully is about the underpinning works, because we have to carry out a lot of excavation below ground, and we also have to ensure that the lanes on the road surface are safe. And I understand that the engineering team of the MTRCL has been monitoring that very closely, so I'll be giving you more time to explain to us as to how you carry out the monitoring and surveillance work. And if you discovered any problems in the process, that's what we are concerned about. And we also need to know about Sai Yang Pun Station and the Hong Kong U Station. It's about the water seepage problem, because earlier on the press reported that if there is a downpour out there, then there will be a small out there'll be a small downpour inside. In fact, that has to do with underground water, because within the tunnels, the underground water seepage is very common. And therefore, engineering-wise, you will have to prevent the seepage. You will also have to divert the underground water so that it would not become a nuisance. So I'll give you some time to explain the situation to us. Thank you.
Dr. Wong. Thank you, Chairman. I'll ask the first question and Mark will answer the second question. As for the underpinning works, they are being carried out at the existing tunnel. So we are very careful. We have already put in a number of surveillance points. So we have to ensure safety, and I'm sure we're up to standard. Just now, members asked about water seepage at Sai Ying Pun Station. Earlier on, I also talked about this. Maybe Mark can tell us more about these two issues.
For the underpinning works at Admiralty, as we stated in the paper, safety and avoiding any disruption or impact to the railway structures has been our primary focus. So the works method and design has always taken into account trying to mitigate the risks. The design is quite conservative, and we've always included redundancy in the design so that if something does happen, there's a fallback and a fail-safe. If we talk about the monitoring, for example, there are four different monitoring systems, so that if one of those systems suffers a problem, there are other systems in place that can also report the same information. That monitoring information is collected and is reviewed on a web-based system so that the information is available real-time to the project and engineering team. So if anything happens, they can react accordingly. A similar approach is also taken for the structures that are supporting the railway. We have a number of temporary columns, and we have more temporary columns than we actually need, so there's a redundancy in the number of columns. And they are monitored for movement and level, and if anything happens, then we take immediate action. In the works that we've carried out so far, and we've reported that 83% of the excavation has been completed, we have had no incidents where there's been any movements beyond what we anticipated in the design. So there have been very, very small amounts of movement, and that's to be expected, and that's predicted by the design, and the movements we've had are within those ranges. The section we've now completed is the majority part of the underpinning zone, and we now have some of the permanent columns in. So in terms of the risk to the railway, it's not been totally eliminated, but it's been largely eliminated. I'll just mention briefly for WIL, for the leaks, as we've stated, this is not unexpected. We have had leaks on other stations during other projects. We try to avoid it in the design, but we do expect to carry out some grouting afterwards, and we're doing those works now. We'll also put in place some measures so that that water never gets near the public or any of the sensitive equipment. So the situation is under control.
Okay. Leung Kwok Hong, you.
Leung Kwok Hong, please. Now, if the Undersecretary is going to lead a British soccer team, he would have been fired. He said that it can be done by 2016. Well, for the managers of the soccer teams, they also say that. They also say that they may be able to win the champion, but of course they don't have a chance. But of course, Real Madrid's manager said that, Liverpool's manager said that they all failed. And I think some of them will be fired. So if you lose a football match, you have to go. Well, please go back to the railway. Well, I'm just making an analogy. Well, another soccer team manager says that I should be able to win. Well, Barcelona is playing better than we do, so that's why we lose. Is that a reason? Well, you told us that you have things unexpected. This is the most important thing about an engineering project. On every line, you say that. Just now, Wong Kwok Hing said that the Occupy movement caused a lot of problems to the Admiralty station. And now there are problems with the underpinning works. And now you have three levels underground. Well, ever from Lin Tong onwards, you have been telling us that there are unexpected underground issues. Well, the soccer teams can also say that things are unexpected. They don't know that a match will be like that. They didn't expect that the goalkeeper of the other team will be that good. Every time we are told the same stories, either it's ground problems or the project itself is very difficult. Now you are digging three levels underground. Of course it's difficult. Just now, who said that at MOT? How do you control the crowd? Well, now you are digging three levels underground. You told us that, well, there will be no problems. But of course this will be a major problem. How come people are paying you to carry out these works? You have made a wrong estimation. What kind of logic is that? You know this is a huge, you knew this would be a huge challenge. So how come you are implementing so many projects at the same time? You don't even have enough people. And that gentleman said that some of the data can be found online. Well, why don't you give a copy to the undersecretary, and the undersecretary can give it to the secretary. The secretary can ask the government engineer to look at it. Now, undersecretary, has the MTRCL given you all the relevant data? If you have the data, please give them to us. Give him time to reply. Then I will put the data online, and I can ask all the engineers in the world to look at these data. Ask them to help Hong Kong. Put it online and ask the other engineers whether this design is feasible. We are paying you so much. Now you lose the game and you ask us for more money. You want tens of millions of dollars, and that CEO took away a huge amount of gratuity. So can you give us all the non-confidential documents? I will load all these documents online and see if other engineers can help us. Undersecretary, this is a question for the government. Next, Hong Wai Kang. Thank you, Chairman. The MTRCL is a listed company. It wants its books to look good. When I look at SILE in the paper, well, it seems that it's a very pretty project. You say that the progress is completed by the project is completed by 85%, and it's only 10% different from the originally planned 95%. So on the surface, it's not a big gap. However, you still cannot tell us the commissioning date. You hope it will be 2016. However, due to the underpinning works at MOT station, I don't think you will be bringing us a good news very soon. I think the next meeting you may say there will be another delay and telling us another bad news. We are very concerned about this. As for project problems, yes, you've told us a lot about them. But how come you cannot be more honest? You always try to whitewash these projects, and this will lead to misunderstanding. When I look at past reports, in the middle of last year, only half of the works at MOT station was completed. Of course, you can clarify about this point. Now, are you recovering much of the delay? You say that some of the problems can be resolved fast. And also, a third question. For SIL, let's not look at MOT station. Actually, I've talked to some of the project members. They say that for the tracks and the stations, they are basically okay. So everybody's waiting for the works at the MOT station to be carried out. So while we are waiting, how about the maintenance of the existing station and the track works? Because we have been waiting So maybe some of the machines have been idle, have been laid idle for some time. So are they still operating well? Dr. Wong. Members are very concerned about the MOT station and the SIL, and I totally can understand that. In the past 6 months, well, for the underpinning works at MOT station, the progress has been satisfactory, and 80-odd% have been completed. However, 17% are left. If members have visited the site, you can see that there are 12 slots. 10 slots are completed. We only have 2 slots left, but there are still difficulties with these 2 slots. So there are still engineering risks, but we are trying our best to work with the contractor so that the remaining 17% can be completed. For the southern part of the MOT station, the works are smooth. So for the target commissioning date of end of 2016, we have already taken all these factors into account. Now we have thought about train tests, inspections of stations, trial runs, etc. As for maintenance, we won't be needing longer time, so things will be okay. Okay, in second round, we have very limited time, so I give each member 2 minutes for the second round. 4 members will ask questions. Any other members? Priscilla Leung, Gary Fan, Helena Wong, and me. I'll draw a line here. Priscilla Leung. I drive, and I'm also a pedestrian. So at Wongpo Station, I encounter a lot of troubles. For motorists, sometimes it's very dangerous for them to drive there now. So I hope you can explain to us more clearly. And can the Undersecretary help us? Now there are a lot of road diversions. People are very concerned about that. I hope the Undersecretary can answer me. Just now, I asked you about the SIL. For MOT and Kun Tong, there will be delays. How about ferry service? Policy-wise, can you be more open-minded? Because this is not just about Hong Kong and Wongpo. Along Toh Kwa Wan, there are also delays. So I think this will definitely help. Chairman, Ms. Leung asked about a ferry policy. I think I have repeatedly talked to her on various occasions. Even here, we have had discussions about this. As for our ferry policy, now less and less people will take ferries. So ferries should be provided to places where there is no land traffic. And for Wongpo and Hong Kong, this is not the case. So the operator decided not to provide the service anymore. We think that other modes of transport can serve Hong Kong and Wongpo. Ms. Leung did put forward some suggestions. So if some ferry operators can come up with new ideas, the transport department is willing to talk to them. Now you are carrying out construction, so during this period, you have to come up with solutions as well. I'll talk to the Undersecretary later. Mr. Gary Fan, I would like to follow up on my 2 questions. This is for the government, the Undersecretary or the Director of Highway. Now, there are a lot of delays, and if these delays cannot be recovered, when will you admit that there will be a major delay, and when will you make the decision to make the announcement? And also, another question for Mark. In the paper, you say that you have to do sealing up work, that is when stations are newly opened. So is this quite routine, that is for the past MTR projects you have been doing this, that you have to do sealing up works after the stations are newly opened? How come in the past we haven't seen cases like this, that is like those stations and WIL which are suffering from major water seepage? Government? Well, for any railway project or timetable,
what
if the MTRCL or the Highways Department find out that the progress is such that it cannot be completed on schedule, then we will, as far as possible, give an account to the public. And at present, the thing is, we are not able to tell very specifically. That's because many conditions are still far from clear. But then, as soon as we are able to grasp the situation, and if we are sure that we will not be able to complete on time, then we will definitely be telling you as soon as possible. Yes?
As has been said earlier, for deep underground structures which are below the water table, there is a large pressure of water trying to get into the structure. So after completion, it's not unusual to have some minor leaks and not unusual to carry out some grouting.
But then what about the other parts of the island line? That is, within a month of decommissioning, there was seepage, because that has never happened before. So why? All right, Helena Wong, Chairman. Well, I'd like to ask about Para 23. Saying that the number of entrance and exits would be increased. So what's the current consideration? Is that possible? That is about the ingresses and egresses. And also, well, for Huangpo, they'd like to have more entrances so that for the nearby housing estates other than Huangpo Garden, they would find it more convenient to come over to the station. And then for the Huangpo Station and Homantin Station, in terms of the increase of the number of exits, would that be feasible? So can you increase the number of exits? MTRCL or the government? Increasing the number of exits or entrance? Yes, Mr. Chow? Well, concerning the number of entrance and exits, well, we've also talked to the community when we planned the project. Well, basically for Homantin Station, there would be exits connecting the neighboring housing estates, including Homantin Estate, Oymin Estate, and also Chatham South, that is Hong Hum south of Chatham Road, and also Chung Hau Street, Fat Kwong Street, and so on. As for Huang Po, the current entrances and exits, we have four right now, and then two at the design stage have also been put to consultation with the Huangpo community so that they would be connected to the shopping center. There will be integrated development, so when compared to the original design, it's an improvement. So it's been incorporated into the shopping center. And then on the other side, there are two exits on Hong Kong Road. All right, thank you. Sorry, because of the time pressure, you will have to raise that at other forums. You can also write into them, asking for a written reply. But about the claims, just now you said that the Occupy movement has resulted in the contractor filing a claim against the MTRCL. So my question is, if the MTRCL receives such a claim, so would you be paying that out of your own pocket, or would you be claiming the Occupy participants in turn? And there is also water seepage in the station. Yes, you said that it would not affect the structural integrity or safety, but then if it's going to last for a long time, then that would also affect the durability of some of the materials. From the very beginning, we understand that it's a deep structure below the water level. So has there been any jerry building, or have there been problems? For example, you have not increased the draining system resulting in such problems. So I'd like to put this to the MTRCL. Yes, thank you, Chairman. Concerning the issue of the SIL on the Admiralty Station, because of the Occupy movement, there was a claim, and if the claim was justified, in other words, they have to give us the justifications and what actually happened on the ground, and they will have to show that that had indeed affected their works, then we would check if their claim is reasonable, and where there are justifiable claims, then that would be paid out of from the contingency fund of the project. So will the MTRCL in turn claim against other parties? Well, we will have to check. We will have to look at the circumstances and the merits of the case. And the second question is about the water seepage. In fact, generally speaking, well, if you dig very deep into the ground, it's not uncommon to see water seepage. But then after we have done the mitigation works, and we call that grouting, or we call that injection, and after the grouting works, that would stop the water seepage, and that would not affect the structural safety or integrity. Next, Mr. Kwok Wai Kong, I would also like to ask about water seepage, because in building maintenance, we cannot just stop the seepage by grouting once. Well, when it comes to underground water, you cannot stop the source of the water. So in the investigation report that will be available shortly, will you be looking at the mitigation measures for water seepage? Will you tell us exactly what needs to be done? I don't think that by grouting just once, you'll be able to resolve the problem once and for all. Yes, MTRCL. Yes, thank you, Chairman. Well, I'm not referring to tunnels. In many buildings, in the basement, if you dig very deep, and if the basement is very deep, and if you've been to the underground car park, you'd see water seepage. So water seepage can be diverted by a very small underground water channel. So it's not uncommon. And just now, we refer to the grouting method, because generally speaking, after the excavation has been done, and for the rock surface that is exposed, usually we would just do grouting, and that would also be the water prevention level or lining, and it might have been damaged, and therefore we will have to do some grouting in order to fill in the gaps. So that would be monitored closely for the entire length of the tunnel, whether it's a pedestrian subway or the platform tunnel or whatever. So we will monitor closely the water seepage situation, so that at different times, internally, we would also be submitting or preparing our own report to see how the condition is like. Okay, thank you. We have completed our discussion on this item, and I'll take a 5-minute break, and then we'll resume. So you can raise your hands for the time being, and then we'll jot that down. So 5-minute break.